Okay. First is Christian. So the Allemande. I always have a lot to say about Baroque music and style, but anyway, I'll try to keep it short. The Allemande had a nice flowing tempo. One must keep in mind that Allemande is still a dance, although it is often slow and has many notes. So you need to emphasize the first and the third beat a little bit more, then it would give more structure to the music. As I said, remember, it is a dance, so it can't be too slow, can't be too fast, because then you won't be able to fit in all the notes. So it has to be a comfortable tempo, but still in the style of the Allemande, which is a French dance. I'm not sure, maybe you have read up about the characteristics of an Allemande, but if you haven't, maybe now is the time to go and do a little bit of research so you know exactly how it's supposed to sound. I do know that they when they danced this, it was like a student of mine says, it was to show off the dresses. So it was quite slow, quite elegant, never too fast, but with those strong first and third beats so that it still has the effect of a dance. And follow the musical line a little bit more. It's very logical where you should go louder and softer. When the line goes up, usually we go a little bit louder. When the line goes down, we usually play a little bit softer. But always has to be very, very elegant. Hungarian dance, totally different type of dance. This was a lively performance, very nice sound production, nice gutsy lower strings. Tonation generally good, and the tempo indications were well observed and played. For instance, all the push and pull of the Ritz and odd tempo, etc. Well done on this one. Schindler's List, beautifully played with a suitable atmosphere, good intonation and bow control. Just a technical thing, maybe try to achieve from now on the same quality of sound that you have on the lower strings on your E string. But anyway, well done on your recital. You show a good sense of musical style. You got honors. And then we have Tamsyn. Tamsyn, you chose a very difficult program. So the Allegro. You started with a lively tempo. And again, I also said try to emphasize the first beats a little bit more. Let me just pick something out. And then the second and the third beats should be a little bit lighter. Again, as I said to Christian, it adds to the structure of the style of this music. Take care with intonation. You started off well and then sort of struggled to keep it up. I know it's very tricky as a string player, but do try to fix the intonation as you go along. It's sometimes when you're performing, it's difficult to hear, should I go higher or lower? That's just something that we all have to learn how to do it. I think this piece especially can do with a little more slow practice. It is technically difficult. So I maybe spend a little more time, but again, as I said before, 6 weeks on since you made the recording, so today it might sound totally different. I'm just trying to advise you, you know, what the process would be to improve. We all somehow need to feel that we can play something in tempo before we have the patience to go back and practice it slowly. So maybe now would be a good time to do that. The romance. Always look at the title of your piece and really understand what you are playing. I thought you could experiment with your sound production a little bit more. Try to achieve different kinds of colors, especially because it's called romance. I thought piano can be a little bit softer and sometimes more tender in certain places. Also you need to work on the intonation a little bit more so that you feel really comfortable all the way through. And then Hey Barn Blues, it had a nice bluesy feeling. The rhythm was good and quite precise, good sense of style. And I like the way you played the pizzicatos. In general, These are all very difficult pieces, so I think it would be good to spend some more time on all of them so that you feel comfortable with all the tricky bits. Nevertheless, well done and keep up the good work. You got a merit.